Now guys, we're gonna renew the brake fluid. I always use Kestrel React Performance .4. It's a good brake fluid, never had a problem with it. So, we're gonna use this one. First thing we're gonna do is get this one horizontal. Let's see, is this the one? No. Then it's this one. And that's Torx 30. Okay. Hop, like this. Yes, and now we're gonna cover everything with towels. Okay, this one out of the way. So, yes, over there. Then over here. So. Yes. Now we're gonna loosen this one. Wow, it's a very nice, tiny, ultra tiny Allen. Yep. Okay, this one. Okay, then. Okay, bit of moisture into it. This one too. Hop, out of the way, then it's all the way down. So, yes, now I'm gonna suck out as much brake fluid as I can. Okay, who's on top of it? Okay. Gonna give this a nice clean. Okay. We're gonna attach this one onto the caliper. Okay, and give it a tiny, because luckily you have the length of this tube. Okay, then already had filled my smaller canister. Gonna put the brake fluid in here. Okay. Now we're gonna open, close, open, close, open, close, open, close. Keep an eye on your reservoir. Open, close, open, close. now we are also filling the calipers. Yes. Always need a bit more because it also has to go to the ABS module. But already start to feel really good. The brake fluid is very clear, so carefully get your hose off. Sure, it's down. Down, down, deeper and down. Then, hop. Okay. And the old mechanic special trick. Yes, now we go to the other side. And we're gonna do the same. Pop up the hose on top. And guys, open, close, open, close. Fill it. So okay. Open close. Okay, now brake fluid is wonderful, clean on this side too. Okay, then take the hose off. Out of the way. Okay. Yes. Then we're gonna do the same. Needs a bit more horizontal. It's not. Wait a minute. Aye. Huh. this is better. Now, over here, we have an air screw too. So, we're gonna see. Yes. Needs a tiny bit. Okay. Okay. Few bubbles comes out. Even more. Have to keep an eye on our reservoir. Still see bubbles. Wait a minute. It's now on 4. Oops, these are the bubbles from my air hose. Don't worry. Oh. Okay, now it's bubble free. Now, this is always. Went good. So. Pop. Now. Wait. Okay. Then. Take out. And then, guys, this one. So, I'm gonna leave it there for a moment. Put this one back to 4. Nice. Good, very nice. This was nice. Lean it over to that side, just for the fun. Okay. This stuff. First, nice. This is nicely dry. This one. Top. Okay. Then, guys. Okay. Oh. diaphragm. Nice, good, clean, especially this one, this. Okay, then turn it inside out. Hop. Nice. Hop. Watch. Brand new. Okay. Then we have this one, plastic thing. Not sure. It holds the diaphragm in place. Okay. Perhaps you can see it over here are tiny slits. Be sure those are open. Nice. Okay, then the cap. Yep, nice, 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 nice. Now we're gonna fill it. Have to hold it. Wait a minute, we have to put it a bit up. So, like this, then. Wait a minute. It's always difficult to see. But this one, wait a minute. Yes, wait a minute. So now it's exactly horizontal. No, not. So, like this. Yep. Guys, I always put it a mil, just a tiny bit, underneath the max level. Wait a minute, just so. Because when you fill it exactly to the max and you push this one in, brake fluid squirts out. By now, see, almost touch. That's good. Then my especially rubber thing. Give this clean too. Okay. Screw the cap on. Not too tight. Tight. But not too tight. Okay. Then we have over here. This one. Enough. Okay, this is a bit loose. I don't like it. So, let's see what I can do about that. I think this is this side. Yep. Over there. Guys, yep, okay. That's always the problem. I'm gonna show you. There is this bushing, and over time that rubber wears and then it comes loose. So you have to sand a mill off of that one, and then it's tight again. Let's do that. I sand it a tiny bit off, a mill. Bit hot. Okay. Okay, then. Yes, that's better. Kijk, now it's loose, but not too loose. Much better. Well done. Now, we're gonna get this back in its original position. That's not difficult. Wait a minute. First, I'm gonna loosen this one. Okay. Then. Okay. Now, I'm gonna show you a trick. Always works for me. Is feel with your hands if they are. Now watch a tiny bit. Do that. Yes, and then tighten them. Okay, not too tight, but tight. Now, let's move on. The last thing we're gonna do is mount this one back. So easy. Over there, over there. Then guys. Over here. Be sure you have those washers. And the right Torx. Okay, this one. Okay. I'm gonna do a drip of Loctite medium strength. So I'm sure my bolt stays in place. Okay. man. A bolt with a washer and a drip. Loctite. Okay. Hop. So. Okay. Over here, I can still feel that old Loctite. Okay, now, not gonna tighten them all the way. So, a bit loose. Go to the other side. And we're gonna do the same and then we tighten them. And then, I'm gonna show you one more trick. Still got tricks to show you. Now, bolt and a washer, a bit of Loctite, let's see, where are the holes? Yep, it's over here. Okay, then the last one. Oh, bit of Loctite. Close the bottle. Now, there he goes. So, not too tight. This one out, that wonderful rubber cap on again. Okay, we're gonna tighten the other side, and then you're almost done. Almost done. Okay. Okay. The rubber cap, nice. Okay, get my dirty fingers off. We're gonna do a final test. Now watch. Have my front wheel off the ground. Give it a shake and then perfect. So you can feel if your pistons don't stick, but this is normal. These are, yeah, new brake pads. I think after one or two brakes, that's gone, that's sliding. Okay, thank you. Then, there is still one thing we have to do, is mount back its wireless charger. Hop. Now guys, that was my video about how to get the front wheel out, get the front wheel back in, put new brake pads onto the bike, onto this BMW S1000R, put new brake fluid into it. Was that difficult? No way. Can you do it? Absolutely sure. No. I hope you enjoyed this video. And if you do, please consider a subscription. Give me thumbs up. Also good. And for now, Old Mechanic.